The stars of HGTV's Flip or Flop, Christina Hoch and Tariq El Moussa, have certainly been through the ringer and have come out the other side doing better than ever. Here's everything you need to know about Christina and Tariq's modern-day relationship. After getting divorced from Tariq El Moussa, Christina El Moussa became Christina Anstead. Following her separation from Aunt Anstead, she then decided to revert to her maiden name of Christina Hoch. So did El Moussa and Hoch become comrades-in-arms after Hoch went through another devastating split? Well, yes and no. El Moussa told Entertainment Tonight that, to the best of his knowledge, Hoch was doing great in the aftermath of the split. He echoed the sentiment in a chat with Us Weekly, saying that Hoch was faring well. He didn't get too into the details of her business, however. In a separate interview with Us Weekly, El Moussa insisted, quote, "I prefer just to stay out of it." Having said that, though, El Moussa acknowledged that he understands why people are so invested in his ex's relationship status. He said, "People have watched kids born, people have watched us raise kids, they watched us get divorced, they know us, they've been following our lives for almost 10 years, they feel like they're a part of it, which makes sense." In the brief time that Christina Hoch was married to Aunt Anstead, the couple welcomed a baby boy named Hudson. With Christina and Aunt both having two children of their own from previous relationships, Hudson was the fifth child in this couple's blended family. According to Us Weekly, Tariq El Moussa was more than accommodating when Hoch was in the hospital with Hudson, taking the kids they shared together to the hospital to visit her, all while he was still in the process of filming during the day. Balancing work and life and the needs of their children isn't simple, but they make it look easy. Christina Hoch and Tariq El Moussa seemed to be killing it on the co-parenting front, but it wasn't always easy. Hoch told Us Weekly that Brayden, her son with El Moussa, was only 9 months old when they separated, but their daughter Taylor is 5 years older than her brother, so she was a bit more clued in as to what was going on. Despite the difficult circumstances, they made it work, with both Hoch and El Moussa determined to stay positive around their kids. Hoch emphasized how important it is to make her kids the priority. She explained that they make an effort to stay positive around them and show up together at school functions, sporting events, and other activities to let them know they care. So what's the secret to their success? According to Hoch, communication is key. She said to Us Weekly, "It's important when you're co-parenting to make sure that you're on the same page. We have a schedule where we make sure that if one of us has to travel, that the other picks up for the other one. And we just make sure that whatever's best for the kids is what we're going to do." If you've gotten only one impression of Christina Hoch and Tariq El Moussa's current-day relationship, it should be their commitment to their kids. The exes are so determined to give their children a happy and healthy upbringing that despite any personal history between the two of them, they still only live just 5 minutes away from each other. Hoch told Us Weekly that before they came back into each other's orbits, she and El Moussa used to live about half an hour away from each other. According to her, that arrangement was a nightmare, she said. "As you can imagine, you've got school and soccer and stuff, so if we leave a pair of shoes or there's a soccer ball, it's so easy now to just, like, run over there and pick something up. It's just a lot more simple. The kids' schools are close, and everything is like a 5-minute drive." El Moussa and Hoch might be stars on screen, but they also clearly know how to respect one another. Considering that there are kids and business interests involved, it's great to see just how well they seem to be doing. Fans of Flip or Flop know that Tariq El Moussa and Christina Hoch have a tendency for on-screen bickering, whether they're married or not.
Do you?
I do. I just don't think it works.
But sometimes those professional spats can turn into personal attacks that the audience doesn't get to see. Flip or Flop director Michael Pando recalled in an interview with Today that one of the most difficult days on set was in 2016. The former couple got into an argument about a design, but things escalated quickly.
"One of the worst days that we had on set, they started getting an argument and it was over a design issue, but, you know, with everything going on, it became personal and other things came up."
Pando revealed that it was up to him to pump the brakes on the couple's argument when their fight left the topic of home design behind. He said, "As the director, I kind of sat back just listening to see when they were going to cross the line, and when they did, then I jumped in and I got in the middle of it." But the fighting between El Moussa and Hoch that so many of us have come to know might be finally fizzling out. El Moussa told E! News that he and Hoch have never gotten along more than they do now. Since their separation, they've learned how to value each other differently. El Moussa shared, "Our relationship is in a completely different place. She and I are getting along, we're co-parenting, getting along together, and I really think the episodes are getting better and better." If you ask a fan of Flip or Flop what their favorite part of the show is, don't be entirely surprised if they say it's the quick and witty dynamic between Christina and Tariq. The relationship between the exes is just as sharp and fast-paced off-camera as it is on, as evidenced by Hoch's calling out El Moussa in a promotional post he made for a new episode of the show. El Moussa took to Instagram in late April to share with fans that his and Hawk's favorite renovation from the season would be airing in an upcoming episode. As he put it, quote, "This was one of our favorite flips we've ever done. I swear I'm not just saying that." Clearly, the wording of his post didn't ring true to Hawk, because she quickly went to the comments and refuted her ex's remark. She posted, "Wrong episode. Tonight's is Norwalk. I don't think it's your favorite ever, but it's still a good one. LOL." It all goes to show that she's not shy about calling out her ex when she needs to, whether it's on screen or not. Who said that divorced people couldn't get along? Your ex moves on, great, but all of a sudden their new partner is a part of your life? Sounds kind of tough. But from the looks of it, Christina Hawk and Tarek El Moussa's fiancé, Heather Rae Young, all managed to get along. As noted by Us Weekly, Hawk and Young have a system in place so that they can communicate with each other about Taylor and Brayden. The children Hawk and El Moussa share with each other, Young told the outlet. "We co-parent very well together. We communicate daily about the kids, and they're the most important thing in the world to all of us, so as long as the kids are happy, we're all happy. Honestly, we love to see it, because kids of divorce aren't always made the priority." Young went on to say that the most difficult part of integrating herself into the kids' lives had to do with their ages when she entered a relationship with El Moussa. As she recalled, "They respect me as their bonus mom. They love me. I love them so much, but I think the most challenging thing was coming in when they were already 3 and 8, and they're already little people. They already have the personalities, they already had a routine. I came in after the fact." Teamwork makes the dream work, right? Well, sort of, and if you're looking at the dynamic between Tarek El Moussa and Christina Hawk, having a healthy amount of disagreement might not be a bad thing. Even though they've worked on their relationship post-divorce, the one-time power couple still find ways to bicker with each other on camera, adding a little bit of spice to their specific brand of reality TV. And while their tiffs are a lot more about work now and far less about their personal lives, Flip or Flop fans can still tune in to a classic Hawk-El Moussa disagreement. During an episode in Season 9, El Moussa and Hawk were renovating a 3-bedroom, 2-bathroom house in California. They only had a renovation budget of $82,000, so they were stretched pretty thin, and of course disagreed with a number of choices along the way. For example, Hawk wanted a yellow front door for the renovation, but El Moussa went with a blue one instead. Hawk wanted to go for a retro kind of style and opted for a pink tile for the kitchen backsplash, but as you may have guessed, El Moussa killed that idea too. The tension between them had the same feel as the series has always had, showing that these two know how to push each other's buttons whether they're living together or not. You won't be surprised to hear that there are a couple of downsides to having such a public relationship with your ex. Falling in and out of love in front of millions of viewers worldwide means that every detail of your relationship gets accounted for, and every little inch of your life gets put under a microscope. So it shouldn't come as a huge shock to find out that despite their good working relationship, Christina Hawk won't be invited to Tarek El Moussa's wedding to Heather Rae Young. Speaking to Entertainment Tonight in April 2021, El Moussa confirmed that the famous exes wouldn't be reuniting for his and Young's wedding. According to him, the gathering will be a small one. He said, "No, no exes at the wedding. Small, less distractions, more intimate, better conversations with the people around us. You know, we just think smaller is better. Sounds good to us." Young echoed the sentiment, saying that her wedding to El Moussa is going to be an intimate affair among best friends and family. She also added, quote, "We're gonna have to be strict with our list." It's safe to say that a lot of people were surprised to find out that Christina Hawk and Tarek El Moussa were joining together on screen once again for Flip or Flop, even after their separation and divorce. It's not hard to understand why people were a bit thrown either. How many divorced couples could keep seeing each other regularly? So what motivated Hawk and El Moussa to push through their differences? El Moussa said that they'd both worked too hard to give up what they'd started together. Speaking in an interview with Today, El Moussa and Hawk explained why they thought maintaining a working relationship on Flip or Flop was worth it.
Series of 12, so we've been doing this for a really long time. It's part of who we are and what we do, and for us to just throw everything away, it just wasn't worth it.
Hawk followed up the sentiment by saying that during their time on Flip or Flop, they'd welcomed two amazing kids into their lives, so it was in everyone's best interest that they learned to work together even after their romance fell apart. If you've been wondering how Tarek El Moussa's fiancé feels about him working in such close proximity with his ex-wife, then you're probably not alone. From the looks of it, El Moussa's fiancé is perfectly okay with the situation. Heather Rae Young of Selling Sunset told Entertainment Tonight that she's never been concerned about El Moussa working with Hawk, and simply stated that the relationship is a part of the job. She said, "It was never an issue because it's work. It's his job. They've been filming for 10 years. Who am I to dictate? I am very supportive. We support each other through everything." As far as Young making an appearance on Flipper Flop herself? Never say never. Her wedding to El Moussa is certainly going to be filmed and could very easily make its way onto a show like Flipping 101 or Selling Sunset. We'll just have to see what happens as the lives of this remarkable group of house flippers continue to unfold. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more List videos about Flipper Flop are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.